But we've got some breaking news coming in here from Shams Charania of The Athletic and Stadium. Miami and Memphis are in advanced discussions for Andre Iguodala to land with the Heat. League sources tell The Athletic and Stadium. Wow, so we don't know the particulars here, but Shams breaking some big news. There was the threat that Andre Iguodala would not report. He was going to hold out unless he got a buyout. Incredible situation here for the Memphis Grizzlies to find a home in the Miami Heat. And again, we'll get out to live looks and updates from these nine games, but the night is going to be headlined by potential and deals that do get done here. So B. Wood and Sekou, not only does the team that gets Andre Iguodala benefit from his experience and his ability to ball hand and defend, you know, basically five positions on the court, but also you keep him out of the hands of one of your opponents.
Yeah, if you're Memphis, you send him to the East Coast, so you don't have to worry about playing him in the first round. But I want to be I'm interested to see how this thing works. We always thought that Andre Iguodala was going to get bought out. Well, now, if it's a trade, he's making $17 million. Part of the reason why those young guys in Memphis are so mad, he's the highest paid player on their team. So $17 million worth of play or some assets is going to have to be sent back to Memphis. So I wonder, what player from Miami will be on the move or what assets Miami has?
You got some contracts in Miami that could be packaged and moved now. I mean, we're talking about Deion Waiters. You know, James Johnson, they got some.
I don't know if they want Deion Waiters in Memphis.
I don't know if they want him in Miami, but I'm saying you got to make a deal.
Come on, man.
You got to get a deal done, right? It's deal season, right?
Not that type of deal.
We're on the clock.
Yeah.
3 o'clock, Thursday.
I'll let the clock run out before I take Waiters right now.
I mean, I'm just saying, Miami has a structure in their salaries where they could make something happen. They could get a deal done if they need it. And can you imagine this Heat team, the way they've been playing at home, the way they've been playing defensively, adding Andre Iguodala to that roster? That changes, to me, the entire complexion of the Eastern Conference race, because then you vault Miami up even higher in your mind about what they could potentially do in a playoff setting. Their rookies will be more than rookies by the time we get to mid-April. Andre Iguodala will be a masterstroke for the Heat. That would be an absolute masterstroke if they pull that off.
And at the first part of the show, we talked about this Miami Heat team and what they struggle to do, and that's win games on the road, and that's because they're a young ball club. At home, they're great. A lot of teams come to South Beach and get the South Beach flu, and the Heat take advantage of that. But on the road, they are a 500 ball club, and that's because they're a young team that's still trying to figure out their identity and how to win games when they don't have the crowd behind them. You bring in Andre Iguodala, another vet to that locker room that fits the culture. I definitely think this team will be better because of it.
No question. You have Goran Dragic, Jimmy Butler, and Andre Iguodala. Unbelievable.
Again, the news from Shams. He says Miami and Memphis in advanced talks to get a deal done to send Iguodala to South Beach. Will D'Angelo Russell's Warriors career last beyond?